Honorable Sri V. Vijay Sai Reddy.
Thank you, Deputy Chairman, sir. I would like to state that I, on behalf of our party, fully support the bill as it helps to resolve retrospective tax disputes with the government on which it has to incur a lot of costs for international litigation, and this will eventually also promote the trust between the foreign companies and the government, and it positively impacts our ease of doing business. So we appreciate the Honorable Finance Minister for bringing this amendment bill. I hope the Honorable Minister, Honorable Finance Minister, from now onwards, not only in respect of this Section 9, Subsection 1, Subclass 1, Explanation 5, read with 147, 153A, 153C, 143, 144, not only these sections, I hope Honorable Finance Minister from now onwards will not bring any amendment in the Income Tax Act in SOPA with retrospective effect. This is the assurance what the then Finance Minister, after BJP came to power, the Honorable Arun Jaitley ji has assured the House that no retrospective amendments insofar as Income Tax Act is concerned. I hope the Honorable Finance Minister also will adhere to that, and so that the protracted litigations could be avoided. Sir, 2012 amendment has brought us a lot of criticism from the international quarters, as it was passed to overturn the Supreme Court judgment in Vodafone case, which has held that the capital gains arising from the indirect transfer of Indian assets are not taxable under the then existing provisions of Income Tax Act 1961. See, this is the amendment which the Congress party has brought in, which is very unfortunate. This is to overturn the Supreme Court judgment. It means that in an asset which is located in India, where the management control is located outside India, and there is a transfer between two individuals outside India, and that capital gains are not taxable. This is the essence of the amendment, which is very, very unfortunate and against the true spirit of Indian taxation. And Honorable Finance Minister has brought the amendment rectifying the analysis. We really appreciate the Honorable Finance Minister. The move by the center paves way for companies including Vodafone and Cairn to withdraw the litigation in the Indian international courts with an assurance from the government that its demand for retrospective tax will also be withdrawn. It is also proposed to refund the amount paid in these cases without any interest thereon. So I draw your kind attention, Honorable Finance Minister, Madam, and as I have pointed out, it is not only in respect of the sections which the Amendment Act deals with, and even in respect of other sections also, Section 220, which deals with the interest, and Section 221, which deals with the penalty. In all the cases, we expect you not to bring any amendments retrospectively from now onwards. Sir, recently, an international tribunal awarded $1.7 billion to Cairn Energy to be paid by the Indian government. This will accrue a huge amount of savings to the exchequer and settle 15 years old transaction, which has adversely impacted India's efforts to project itself an investor-friendly destination. So we appreciate that. So final, last point, sir. This should hopefully allow more tax certainty, but it is expected that the government not just foregoes the tax demand of such indirect transfers before 2012, but also any dispute that could arise retrospectively in the years 2012 to now also. Sir, leaving this grey area will take away the conclusiveness of the proactive steps taken by the government. We hope the government, Honorable Madam, can start afresh and leave the regimen of retrospective tax behind us and encourage the higher foreign direct investment flow into the country. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Honorable Vijay Sai Reddy ji.